bless you, brother and sister. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and it's time to be wherever you're watching or listening to me. An opportunity once again to come to your homes at such a time like this with the Word of God. I bless the name of the Lord for your life. And this is what the Lord has laid in my heart this morning, this afternoon, this evening to share with you. It's a story found in the book of Matthew, chapter 26, from verse 36 through 42. It's the story of why Jesus Christ was at the Garden of Gethsemane. Garden of Gethsemane, verse 38 declared that, "Then said he unto them, My soul is exceeding sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me." Jesus Christ brought this to the disciples and went to the Garden of Gethsemane because he was confronted with the overwhelming price of his death. The sacrifice was about to be for humanity. He became overwhelmed. He saw death on one and one. He went on before the Lord and asking him, "Lord, Father, can you let the cup of this sovereign pass over me?" Then he quickly said, "Not my will, but let thy will be done." Many of you are sorrowful, grieving. Many of you are burdened. Many of you are bothered. Many of you are worried and concerned over one or two issues in life, concerning your marriages, your career, your businesses, your investments, your children, your husband, your wife, your fiancé, your career. You are worried, you are concerned, and you are about to give up. Jesus Christ at this moment was about to give up. But listen, he quickly went back to himself and said, no, I can't give up. I prayed with you this morning. You will not give up. The power to carry your dream to fruition. Let the power come upon you. You see, you can't do all things without Christ. Bible says you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Because you are in the Lord, you're a child of the Most High God, I pray with you. You will not give up, you will not quit on your dreams, on your passions, on your visions, on your goals in life. You won't quit. The Lord will strengthen you. Listen, there is nothing like you living according to the will of God or living in the will of God. Jesus Christ was about to be distracted by the overwhelming challenge, but he quickly returned back and said, "Let the will of God, I pray that the will of God be done in what you are going through in the name of Jesus. Your sickness is not unto death." Bible said the prayer of the righteous availeth much for you. We have been on this mountain, this is the 18th day, that we'll be waiting on the Lord. I pray prophetically concerning whatever you are believing God for, that the Lord will hear your cry. He will answer your prayer. He will make you a living testimony. You have been celebrating with others. It is your time. It is your turn to be celebrated. I call for celebration galore into your life. As you descend on this mountain, as you descend from this mountain, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, have paid the price for you. So I ask that his name will be glorified. As we say, Christ is in all the hope of glory. Colossians 1:27, I pray that the glory of God will manifest. The power of God will manifest in your homes, in your career, in your family, in the life of that troubled child, that troubled son, even your troubled spouse, either husband or wife, or your fiancé that is behaving. The glory of the Lord will manifest in Jesus' name. As the Lord liveth and saints of God abide there, I pray that the glory of God will manifest as a pastor, a minister, in your local church or churches. I pray the glory of God will not quit on your vision as a minister of God. As a pastor over the flocks of God, you will not quit. The Lord will say help unto you. The Lord will say help unto you. He is our present help in the time of need, according to Psalm 46 verse 1. When you need him most, he will appear, he will not forsake you. Look up unto Christ, the author and finisher of your faith, and it shall be well with you. So I decree to swear with you. I say after the text, say unto the righteous, that it shall be well with them. Until I come your way again, it is well with you, your body, spirit, and soul.